Medicine Sports presents St. Luke's Sports Medicine Game of the Week.
Alumni Stadium here at Penn Argyl High School, the site for Colonial League football action. It's our D11Sports.com Game of the Week presented by St. Luke's Sports Medicine as we kick off the 2023 season with the Wilson Warriors and the Penn Argyl Green Knights. Hi, and welcome, everyone. Al DeCarlo alongside Matt Avancher. So glad you could join us for another year of high school football here on D11Sports.com. So happy to be on the hill here at Penn Argyl and, you know, excited for this matchup as well.
It's a great place to start the season out. You know, always a great venue up here, fall foliage out there off the hill. But, again, two programs that not as successful as they wanted to be last year need to get onto the right track today. We'll see who can come out on top.
Well, we begin with the Wilson Warriors, and their coach right now is Zach Bergstresser in his first year as he got in the mix late here. And one of his key players coming in, and not only for this game, but one of the guys that is going to be the best in the Colonial League, in the area, and maybe in the state, Ian Fecchetti. I'll get back to the other guy afterwards. Ian Fecchetti was a key part of the team a year ago, a key part this time as I'm getting ahead.
He was, and Ian Fecchetti does a lot of things for the Wilson Warriors. Obviously, as a receiver, he's going to be their leading go-to guy, but he also is a leader on defense, playing outside linebacker. They're going to need him to make a lot of stops, make a lot of plays, and then Coach Bergstresser talked about the leadership ability that he's had with the team and how the team responds to him. So that's going to be a huge role he's going to have to take heading into the 2023 season.
Well, for the Penn Argyl Green Knights, they were 5-6 a year ago. Brady Mutton now in his fourth year as a head coach. And now, as I got my head at myself, it is the first game. You know, I do that sometimes. Damian Tominski, one of the best out there for sure.
He is. And, you know, Damian Tominski has all the attributes that you're looking for in a top-notch receiver. Over 1,000 yards last year, but also was able to rush the ball for them when they needed him. And, again, go back to that leadership. We talked about Ian Fecchetti. Damian Tominski, Coach Mutton had said that's the biggest thing, the biggest turnaround he's done this offseason is he stepped up as a leader for this team, and the kids are responding around him.
Well, we'll see what happens as we get ready for this first matchup of the year. We're in Penn Argyl. It'll be Wilson, Penn Argyl, our D11Sports.com Game of the Week presented by St. Luke's Sports Medicine.
At St. Luke's Orthopedic Care, you can trust us with your hands, feet, shoulders, hips, and knees. Because healthy bones and joints mean you can do more. You can trust us to recommend the right approach to care, including joint-sparing treatments and therapies. And when surgery is the only choice, we offer options to help you heal faster, including technology-assisted joint replacements and muscle-sparing hip surgery. St. Luke's, the orthopedic care you trust, now more than ever.
The team that we have put together of sport performance coaches and athletic trainers is why parents should choose St. Luke's University Health Network for their sport performance needs.
St. Luke's and our coaches are going to provide the safest and most comprehensive training environment that a student athlete would want. And I don't think there's anything in this area that can rival it.
We are back here on the hill as the Penn Argyl Green Knights take the field for the first time here in 2023. Chase Eller, a senior at Wilson area, has talked to both coaches, and he has our first report. Chase?
I had the ability to speak to both coaches before the game today, Coach Mutton of Penn Argyl and Coach Bergstresser of Wilson. Each had the same game plan to play hard. They competed all summer for this, so it's time to show it. On the Penn Argyl side, we have Brad Wismiller at quarterback, leading out on a senior team, ready to cap the season off and start it off right. Wants to go out on strong, and he's going to lead this team out there. On the other side, with Wilson, we have Ian Fecchetti leading from the Wilson Warriors. He's playing linebacker, had a strong year last year, is one of the bright spots. And also, we have Damian Tominski for Penn Argyl. So the receiving core that Coach Bergstresser really stressed he needs to stop today is the Wismiller-Tominski combo. If he stops that, it's the game going to be about the same equal playing level. Size is matched up equal. Just have a good game, competitive, and have fun on this nice Saturday. Back to you guys.
All right, Chase, thanks a lot. Chase will be with us for the rest of the game. And with that, let's take a look at today's keys to the game. And we'll begin with the Wilson Warriors. Our keys to the game brought to you by New York Life.
And as we heard from Chase just say, Coach Bergstresser stressed emphatically how they need to slow down Riss Miller and Tominski. Tominski is a size advantage for Penn Argyl, so that's going to be a huge task for the secondary of Wilson. And offensively, they need to move the ball running and passing. You need to keep the defense off on their heels. They can't let the defense just tee off on the offense. They have to be balanced and keep them moving.
Now, for the Penn Argyl Green Knights, obviously, you know, when they come in with their keys and put themselves in position, we know coming in, and we talked to Coach, he wants to get going right away.
He does. He wants to go behind his offensive line. He wants to get out to a fast start to begin, but then he wants to just grind it out. You know, you take Coach Mutton, he's a former offensive lineman. You're going to get that kind of game plan where they just want to grind out the win and just keep running the ball, keep pounding the ball, and then protect the football.
Well, for 175 years, New York Life has been helping families and businesses with their life, disability, and long-term care planning needs. Whether you have a current coverage in place or in need of reviewing your options, please contact their office in Allentown to find the right plan to fit your needs. Call New York Life at 610-616-4430 today. Take a look at the Wilson Warriors as they will make their way onto the field for the first time. First quarter brought to you by JFR Salvage, which is a full-service scrap metal recycling company serving the Lehigh Valley for nearly 50 years. JFR Salvage will pay you cash for all grades of scrap metal, including iron, steel, copper, brass, aluminum, stainless, and junk vehicles. Competitive pricing and superior service are just a few reasons you choose JFR Salvage for your scrap metal needs. Please visit their website at jfrsalvage.com or one of their locations in Wingap or East Stroudsburg. St. Luke's is the region's largest sports medicine provider, covering more than 200,000 student enrollment and 40,000 student athletes in Pennsylvania and New Jersey, covering 8 counties and providing the most comprehensive and advanced treatment for athletic injuries. St. Luke's offers athletic training, orthopedic care, physical therapy, and concussion management, plus sports performance training for individual athletes and teams. During these extraordinary times, you can trust St. Luke's Sports Medicine to provide extraordinary care. Support for D11Sports.com Game of the Week comes from Michael R. Glovis, financial advisor at Morgan Stanley in Easton. For all your investment needs, call Michael R. Glovis at 610-559-6380, located at 101 Larry Holmes Drive, Suite 301 in Easton, PA. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney LLC, member SIPC. Also want to welcome Culligan Water. Culligan Water asks, when's the last time you had your water tested? Get a free in-home water assessment from Reynolds Culligan. Visit yourwater.net for more information. If you're a student from any District 11 school interested in broadcasting, journalism, and photography, check out d11sports.com. Follow your dream, get close to the action, take part in our student internship program. For more information, contact your athletic director, reach out to myself or Dave at d11sports.com. Matt, we kicked off the season last night. We had about 8 student reporters out there roaming, you know, from up north, Schuylkill County, and also here in the Lehigh Valley. They did a great job in opening night. New reporters, and we got some veteran ones out there as well.
Absolutely. And it's a great way, you're staying at home, you can follow along with everything going on in the Lehigh Valley. They're covering almost every game that was being played last night, and it was nice to keep up and see what was going on.
Well, as far as this matchup is concerned, and I think you and I know it both, we've done it in the past few years, we feel like we're part of this game because we've been doing it so much. You know, a quick start and really, you know, for both teams, you know, obviously at the beginning of the season, we always talk about those early turnovers and, you know, setting the tone that way and everything else.
Yeah, and I think, you know, last year it was an even game for a little bit, and then Penn Argyl just kind of walked away with it a little at the end. It was big plays, actually, that really plagued Wilson last year. So here, you know, Coach Button talked about starting fast. Wilson deferred the opening kickoff. Penn Argyl's going to receive. They're going to get their offense on the field to start the 23 season, and we'll see what they're going to do right away. You know, you have that advantage with Tominski and Riss Miller. Do they go after that right away, or do they just get into that running game and ground it out?
I was just going to ask you, do they go right after it right away?
I think that's something you want to do. You know, I think they probably have been working on that. If it's not this series, it's definitely going to be an early series go-to.
I agree with you. Well, first game of the year, Wilson last year, that was 0-10. Penn Argyl at 5-6. We now pause in Honor America with the playing of our national anthem. We are moments away from kickoff here at Alumni Stadium on the Hill. And while we have Chase Eller as our student reporter down the field, we also have another student reporter, but he's in the game, and he's wearing number 71. He's your center, and that's Braden Kresnopera. He wanted to be mic'd up every time I see him. And we said no chance. We talked to Brady Mutton, and he said no
absolutely
chance.
Absolutely no chance.
So that wasn't going to happen. But we gave him a shout-out because that's what he wanted to be on. So we'll see. But again, a lot of weapons here on Penn Argyl. You start looking at last night, and what game maybe jumped out at you by score-wise? Obviously, the teams that are expected to win are going to win, and there was a couple games last night that became very interesting.
You know, and I think there's a lot of them. I had a chance to see Catasauqua this summer at a 7-on-7 passing scrimmage, and they have a plethora of athletes all around in the skill positions. And they went out and they had a fantastic night against Northern Lehigh last night, who's a perennial powerhouse in the Colonial League. But seeing them come out and establish themselves early is a good showing. Notre Dame coming back, scoring 36 unanswered points in a quarter and a half. Less than a quarter and a half to get out of a huge win last night. Southern Lehigh coach Phil Sams comes out with a big win over Quakertown. And
Field there.
Absolutely nice field. And then you go into the EPC. Freedom won 14-0. You don't know yet. Is how good is Stroudsburg? Is Freedom? They lost a lot of starters from last year, and they're replacing a lot. So how's that? How much time is that going to take? But like you said, some of the teams, Parkland, Emmaus, they kind of went in, and Whitehall, they kind of went in and did what they had to do, come out with a win. Coach Marino at Whitehall, his first win. The new coach at Becca gets his first win. So that's always nice to have, as a first-year coach in a new program, getting that first win, getting off the, kind of solidifies everything we're doing. We're doing it for a reason. It's going to work. So it kind of builds trust with your team.
Officials today, referees Joe DiOrio, Stephen Tones, the umpire, linesman is Kevin Labar, line judges Greg Metzer, back judges Tom Snoddy, field judges Kevin Stocker, and side judges Marcel Simmons. So it is on the tee. And as we get ready for this matchup to get going here from Alumni Stadium, it's the first game here on D11 Sports and the first Saturday of football here in 2023. And it'll be the Penn Argyl Green Knights set to receive, and they will go far side. This will be fielded right around the 19-yard line. And picked up there by Alex Moser. And Moser breaks a tackle, and Moser has some space, and Moser is off to the races. And I don't think anyone's going to catch him as he goes
that's number four, Alex
all the way down for the touchdown, almost 80 yards. Wow.
And that's the way you want to start fast. Coach Mutton said it. He wanted them to start fast. And, if we get to look at this replay, Moser's going to get the credit. He gets the ball, but you're going to see a key block come in right there up top. I can't quite get the number. He levels his guy and frees Moser, gives him the lane back to the left, and it's just him and green grass in front of him. What a way to start the 23 season for Penn Argyl. A great way, and for Alex Moser, getting that start is great for him.
So Penn Argyl on the scoreboard, an 81-yard kickoff return by Alex Moser, and he fielded that one on the 19-yard line, and they'll look for the point after. And that is just 12 seconds into the game. And
Wilson has too many players on the field.
Now they're going to go for two.
Yeah, Coach Mutton switching it up, going for two now. I like that decision early in the game. You get half the distance to the goal, so you only need to get a yard and a half. Yeah, put them in there. Get behind that offensive line. He said he wanted to establish the run game. He didn't get the opportunity on that first drive. You might as well get a chance now.
He realized we're only 12 seconds in, right? A lot of things have happened. We've had a kickoff return for a touchdown. We've had a penalty, and we're going for a two-point conversion. So now an extra player coming onto the field, and that's Michael Thomas. Nope, he gets pulled back off. Quick snap, and the two-point conversion is complete as they get that one to Caden Faust.
Caden Faust, sophomore running back. He's their starting running back. Came in this year, had a good camp for Coach Mutton and the Green Knights. He's going to be a nice complement in the backfield to Brad Rissmiller, who also in his own right can run the ball as well.
So 8-0 in a blink of the eye. We couldn't see their starting lineup, but we'll we'll pop in the starting lineups for the Penn Argyl Green Knights.
And again, as we said, this is going to be keyed by their offensive line. There's some key guys, some returning. You have Cale Grimm, Jacob Geary, Brandon Casnapera. We talked about him. Stephen Hines, Ethan Holland. Those guys are going to be tasked with giving Riss Miller time, opening holes for Faust, and letting Riss Miller find those receivers on the perimeter. Dominski, Moser, Seuss, and also the tight end Michael Thomas. If he can give him time, they're going to have their hands full of Wilson today.
Yeah, and here was the defense for the Wilson Warriors. And you mentioned, you know, these players are going to have to, once they get on the field, you know, without a kickoff return, they're going to be tested, especially downfield when it comes to the D-backs and the free safeties.
Correct.
Well.
And you take a look, Jason Johnson, he's a freshman in there, linebacker. He's filling in for Ziondre Johnson, who's out with an injury. And Coach Bergstresser talked about how he's a key loss, but does feel confident in what Jason Johnson can do in that linebacking position.
So we'll see the offense for Wilson as they will get the ball here for the first time. This one's straight up, and they'll get good field position as that ball is dribbled and popped and now getting out of it for a moment. So they got the ball at the – it looked like at the
– going to be the 30-yard line.
Yeah, 30-yard line. And not much there. Quickly popped on the play.
I think that was 13 Brunson who comes up with it twice there, and both teams – able to come away, luckily. Kickoffs, you always teach your kid, never let that ball touch the ground as much as possible because you never know how it's going to bounce. They're a good opportunity. Brunson luckily gets on it.
We'll take a look at the offense after this play. 8-0 just joining us, 17 seconds into the game, an 81-yard touch via kick return by Alex Moser. And Cressman, he gets taken down immediately on the play. Not even a chance really to make any play as Cale Grimm was quickly in there for the Green Knights.
Yeah, Grimm did not give any time for Cressman or any space, but you'll see the offensive line kind of a little bit young, a little bit new guys in there, but definitely Wilson behind Cressman, who's played over a half of a year last year, and some skill guys, has some talent that if they can get the ball out to him.
Low snap, quick toss. And short yardage pickup here for the Warriors. We'll put him down about third down and six, third down and seven situation.
I think that'll be key for Wilson. You know, with the advantage on the line going to Penn Argyl, Cressman's going to have to be able to get the ball out quickly to his receiver. Short, quick passes.
Cressman third down. Here comes the rush again. He's got a lot of room if he wants to run. He's going to tuck and try to go. Gets upfield and pushes forward. And looks like he has enough for that first down where they're going to mark this one.
Yeah, he's going to get the first down, but you see there, too, you know, more of a drop back pass, trying to get a little bit further down the field. The Penn Argyl Green Knights able to get a lot of pressure on Wilson. It's going to be, if they want to be, have more success, I think they need to go short and quick early on.
So first down of the game. 10:30 on the clock. And they try to go to the ground, but nowhere to go is Brunson. He immediately got taken down on the play.
It was, again, number 21, Caden Faust from his linebacking spot. He comes on a blitz. You see him creeping up in the line there. You have two defensive linemen, two offensive linemen. Caden Faust comes free, and he takes care of that jet sweep quickly in the backfield.
So loses about 6 yards. Cressman standing at his own 30-yard line. Now looking to throw and has a receiver. And he connects right away with Nathan King. And King across the 40 up towards the 45-yard line. So solid pickup. Gets the 6 that they lost. Another 5 after that.
Yeah, and it's, again, Cressman able to get the ball out quickly to his receivers. And each time the receiver able to make one guy miss to pick up some extra yardage. I think even if Wilson can get 5 yards here, you put himself in a position where maybe you still choose to go for it on fourth down.
They go 3 receivers, and it could be a face mask right here, and just taking it and has the sideline and running through. We'll get the first down. Let's see what the call is. But a great run down the sideline by Cressman showing his feet.
Yeah, I think we're definitely getting a face mask. Looked like a Penn Argyl defender just reached over and accidentally grabs the helmet. You'll see him coming in the middle, right in the middle there. The guy that jumps just gets his hand on the helmet. So this gives us an opportunity. I'll talk about the new spotting rules.
Yeah, go ahead.
So new spotting rules came into effect this year for officiating. We'll see how they enforce this, because you have the end of the run down here at the 31-yard line. The penalty occurred back here at the 45 of Wilson. You see the officials talking it out, getting this right.
Are you working today? You're working officiating, or you're working D11 here?
I'm working D11 today.
Okay, just making sure.
I'm working D11.
I'm just saying, you know, if you're going back and
those
forth.
Those hats here. Change, you know, those hats change periodically.
Well, needless to say, for Penn Argyl, excuse me, for Wilson, you know, a good opportunity for them to be in good field position.
Okay, so if I'm not mistaken, we'll let him, Joe DiOrio, talk. Should be declined. It seems like in the new rule, what would have happened was that penalty would have been enforced from the spot.
And this way,
from the previous spot of the ball. So you're going to take the better yardage. The offense will take the better yardage.
So instead, the ball at the 31-yard line for Cressman and company, as Wilson with a solid start. And Cressman's going to go again. Has that middle seam again. He's going to go all the way up for about 9 yards before he's dropped down on the play. How important is it right now? And you're watching Cressman show his feet. You know, they're going trips sometimes the outside, but he's really showing, hey, you better watch me because I'll run.
And I think that's – I was just going to say the same thing. I think now Penn Argyl, you have to think about, okay, who are we keeping in the box to spy him?
They will give him a first down there. Popping out of the defense there is Makai Fields, and still on his feet. If he makes a turn, he's got some space and ends up losing the yards as he came all the way back. He turned two or three times. Now a flag thrown at the end of the play.
I think we're going to get personal foul on Penn Argyl, it looks like. A little bit after the whistle.
Joe DiOrio's got like five microphones going on down there.
Yeah, so I feel sorry for him.
Every now and then, he may hear something. So 8:41 on the clock, and with the penalty, so just like that, the ball is all the way down to the 15-yard line, and this is a great drive. I mean, there's 8:40 on the clock. Again, it was a kickoff return for a touchdown. We have not seen the Penn Argyl offense on the field just yet. And Wilson trying to answer here with a second down and about four and a half. And this one goes through the end zone. That one incomplete. Two Wilson players there, but maybe a miscommunication with the quarterback.
Yeah, it looked like a miscommunication. Cressman looked like he was looking for King to go outside more towards the corner of the end zone. He's coming in. So a little miscommunication brings up third and short. But now this is the play, Penn Argyl defense. They have to have eyes on Cressman. They have to have eyes on him. They can't lose sight of where he's at.
Toss this one there, looking for Fekete, but that one got knocked down. Job defensively by Nolan King.
That was a good play by Nolan King. He saw it was a quick drop, so he stopped his pass rush and just waited and read the quarterback, saw him coming out for the screen, just knocked the ball down.
So our first fourth down opportunity here. Take a look at that Penn Argyl defense.
See how Wilson decides to spread them out. Probably looking to give Cressman some room, maybe to run up the middle.
Here's Cressman, waits, looks to right side, and he sees where it is. Now throws back in the end zone, looking for Fekete. That one incomplete. Had Fekete coming across, just off the fingertips.
That was a good scramble drill by Wilson, trying to get people in the open area. Cressman does a nice job getting out of the pocket, but Penn Argyl stays in contain and kind of keeps him under wraps, not letting him get any running room. We'll see how that drive comes back to play later on in the game, if they need points later on.
So offense comes on the field for the first time this afternoon for the Green Knights, led by Brad Rissmiller. Rissmiller is senior. Boy, we've been calling his name for a long time, huh?
No,
you know, being back and forth and in the mix, you know, passed for almost 2,000 yards a year ago. And he's got weapons, for sure, from the 15-yard line. They've got three receivers near side, one up top. Alex Moser in motion.
Now you can see them trying to isolate Tominski.
And that went for a while, and then this is going to be on the Green Knights, put themselves in a hole quickly.
It's a tough one when you're trying to get all that shifting and all that movement done, and the offensive line has been sitting down there in their stance the entire time. They're just ready to go. They want to come out and hit, and they want to come out and play. You know, just jump the gun a little bit.
Well, you're itching. Like you said, you get out of the locker room, and all of a sudden there's a kick return. You're like, yeah, we're happy for that, but we want to get on the field. So the ball back to the 10-yard line. And nowhere to go was Caden Faust.
And you can see defensively from Wilson, they're trying to load the box as much as they can to protect against that running game, and they're shading the safety over towards Tominski, so they're giving a little bit of a double coverage on him and saying, you have to beat us with somebody else.
So clock midway through quarter number one, 8-0 Penn Argyl on an 81-yard kickoff return by Alex Moser, a two-point conversion by Caden Faust. Only scoring of the game, 12 seconds in. Here, second down and 15, the ball sits at the 10. Rich Miller with a long count. No pressure on him. Throws, and that one is complete. Down the far sideline. And Moser is going to go in 90 yards. How about a start for Moser?
That's a great start for Moser. But again, they're forcing you to have somebody else step up. And, you know, Tominski's going to have to deal with that this season, where they're going to double him. He's going to be the key guy that they're going to look at, and you see they have them both on the same side. Tominski comes to the inside, pulling two defenders, and Moser does a little bit of pushing on the outside to get a little bit of separation, and it's just him the rest of the way for the 90-yard touchdown. Wilson had a chance there at the end, but not able to get enough to bring him down. But again, two great plays by Moser to put Penn Argyl on top.
Wow. That makes it 14-0.
And now that you have it in the shot here, how about the new Penn Argyl scoreboard in the backdrop there?
Fantastic scoreboard.
Yes.
You know,
scoreboard, the new track.
You know, it used to be when you go over here in this time of day, which is usually when the games are obviously, that scoreboard was hard to see.
Yes, it was.
Until, you know, mid-afternoon, and you know, depending on when the game started. So a 15-0 start for the Green Knights.
And you see the Penn Argyl coaching staff getting the whole team together, talking about, you have to think they're talking about the discipline, not giving costly penalties, giving Wilson opportunities like they did on that first drive. They want to shut them down, and they want to continue to go. If they can get a quick stop here and get another touchdown, they're going to put themselves in a great position in this game.
So, Matt, we're only 7.5 minutes into the game. However, Wilson drove well, but they didn't score. But you don't want to dig yourself any bigger hole than this.
You don't.
This is a huge drive here.
And I think they have to come up with some points. And it's going to be, as you saw, as they got down tight, I think you're going to have to go for touchdown. Get their athletes out in space. Obviously, you see Cressman. He's not afraid to run the ball, but he's going to have to be able to use those receivers at different times.
So 15-0 is the start of this game for Saturday afternoon. Penn Argyl will be at home again next week against Mahanoy area, while Wilson will host Palisades in week two. Big game tonight between Northampton and Central Catholic.
I think that's a big game. You're right. I think Northampton, they're looking at that probably a little bit more than Central Catholic, because I think it solidifies a lot of what they're trying to prove, that they belong in those games and in that league. Yeah, I just wanted to check. I'll be back up here Saturday, Al.
Oh, look at you. This one. They're in a good field position. I bet that on the kickoff, nothing there. You'll be back up here when?
I'll be back up here Saturday officiating that game against Mahanoy.
Okay. Now, you realize that if you would have officiated this game, that we could just mic you up. You could just do the game down there, talk to your officials at the same time.
Steve Tone asked if I wanted to switch, if we wanted to make a trade. You know, maybe at halftime we make a trade. I'll go down and finish up the game for him. He can come up here with you. You know, I've known Steve for a long time. He actually, when I started coaching right out of college, I worked with him at Freedom High School with Bill Ryder.
Well, there's a name. All right, so the Warriors will get good field position. They'll start from the 40. They'll go three receivers far side, two to the near side. Cressman going to throw, and he will convert on the pass play to Bronson. Again, about 5-6 yards.
Looked like some timing was messed up there as Fekete was coming in motion, but he's able to come across and pick up a block to give Cressman a little bit more time.
Cressman, nowhere to go this time, and actually somehow gets away from it. And Cressman still on his feet, gets pushed forward, ends up gaining a yard and a half. Now, if you're Penn Argyl and Brady Mutton, you don't want to see that happen. You have four guys on him, and all of a sudden he's breaking a tackle. But if you're Wilson, you're saying, hey, Cressman, keep doing what you're doing.
Exactly. I think Coach Mutton and the defense for Green Knights, they have to figure out a way where they can get those front four guys home to get the sacks and contain Cressman, where they don't have to blitz the two linebackers all the time.
So third down and a long three on the handoff to Fields, and Fields' second effort still going to be short and still pushes forward. So it'll bring up a fourth down in the punting situation, you would imagine, from right here on the field, right around the 47, 48-yard line.
I would think you have to, but it looks like Coach Bergstresser keeping the offense on the field.
That is the big call if you're doing that. You want some momentum one way or the other. You're going to get it here on this play.
Yeah, I believe we are. You know, credit Coach Bergstresser for going for it, believing in his guys, trying to make a statement.
Try to catch him offside a little bit.
I think you have to try.
And call it timeout.
And that could be what they're trying to do. Nope.
They're going for it. Cressman right away. And Cressman pushed all the way back and taken down. So not only do they not convert, but coming on in there was Ethan Holland. Holland makes the play, and it'll be first down and 10 from about the 35 for the Green Knights on a great defensive stop.
And that was time. That was one of those times they were able to get home with just those four defensive linemen. They were able to get the pressure on him and contain and get hands on him and not let him get out in open space.
Now, we talked about putting yourself in position here. If you're Wilson, they had a great first drive after being down 8-0, and all of a sudden there was a three and out. But not only that, look where the ball's sitting.
Yeah, with the ball sitting there, and with Penn Argyl, you see what they're going to come out and do. Coach Mutton said he wanted to get up and he wanted to pound the ball, so here we get a chance to see their running game.
From the 35, and that's straight up on the handoff, and it's taken the other way. And this is Rissmiller. And Rissmiller is going to dive down to about the... So they went for Tominski on the snap to Rissmiller.
There's a flag on the play.
Around the 5-yard line.
See what we're going to get here.
So the stoppage coming with 5:24 on the clock here in the first quarter. Joe DiOrio.
So 10 yards going to come back.
15?
From the flag. So at the 15-yard line. And, you know, I don't know if you're Coach Mutton, if that's a bother. You get the ball, you continue to have the ball, and continue to run the clock and get your offense some work.
Here's Tominski. Tominski finds an opening in the middle part of the field, and he'll go in for the touchdown. Damian Tominski, you know what he can do through the air. This time he takes it 15 yards for the touchdown. Last year, 207 yards and three touchdowns. Here, 15 yards and the score.
And right now, you've seen a lot of the Penn Argyl skilled players getting into the action, but you have to credit this offensive line up front. You know, you get a pool up front, he's kicking out, and it just splits open, wide open. Tominski sees it and then just sticks his foot in the ground, gets up the field for the touchdown to give Penn Argyl Green Knights a huge lead right now.
Extra point is up and good. And the Green Knights take themselves a lead of 22-0 with still 5:19 left in quarter number one.
In that drive, you got to see a lot of all the guys that are at Coach Mutton's disposal. You have Brad Rissmiller, quarterback. He was actually playing a wing in one of the plays. Caden Fowles, the running back, he was playing an up back. Tominski, a wide receiver, he's back as a running back. Mason Sues, wide receiver, he comes back to quarterback. So being able, the flexibility to move all these guys around allows you to be very creative, which is going to keep teams on their heels throughout this season.
St. Luke's is the region's largest sports medicine provider, covering more than 200,000 student enrollment and 40,000 student athletes in Pennsylvania and New Jersey, covering eight counties and providing the most comprehensive and advanced treatment for athletic injuries. St. Luke's offers athletic training, orthopedic care, physical therapy, and concussion management, plus sports performance training for individual athletes and teams. During these extraordinary times, you can trust St. Luke's Sports Medicine to provide extraordinary care. And the kickoff, this one comes to the near side. It's fielded right around the 25-yard line. And not much there for Leonard Davis. And they'll start things off right around the 37. And you said it before, so I'll say it again. This is, you know, your must opportunity to score.
And for Wilson, you've had great starting position. The first drive, you're able to get something going, just weren't able to finish it off. Second drive, you know, you go for it on fourth down. It's early in the game to do that, but they go for it on fourth down, don't get it. But you're right. I think they have to somehow come up with something here. I think even if they just get a drive, they don't necessarily have to come away with points, but they have to start to develop some sort of confidence.
Like the first drive.
Yes.
So Cressman will start things off at the 37. Takes a snap. And that one knocked away. He was looking for Fekete.
And that was Tominski getting up and knocking that down. He was looking for Ian Fekete on his slant. He was a singled up receiver on the far side against Moser. Had some space, but Tominski just comes in and takes that away.
Did you feel that breeze? We just got a breeze here in the press box.
Nice.
That was a great breeze we just got here. So approaching the five-minute mark, Cressman, and he connects, and this has got a lot of space going downfield looking for it and going in for the touchdown. So he didn't think he was going to get maybe 15, but Bronson connects, and he ends up going, 63 yards for the touchdown.
And that's a nice connection. Again, another nice job, Wilson receivers, eluding the first tackler. Again, the pass is thrown within 10 yards of the line of scrimmage, and he catches it right here between the linebackers, eludes the first tackler, and then a little bit of a bad angle by the safety coming in, and he's able to get his way into the end zone.
I don't think Bronson knew there was a player coming in from the angle. He was looking over at the officials who was going down the sideline.
He was looking over at the officials. He's looking over at the stands. I'm not sure he knew there was somebody coming behind him.
Nickerson, Louis June. Brother Anderson June, who played a year ago. And that's a huge touchdown for Wilson with 4:54 on the clock. Matt, if I asked you, and I didn't ask you this to be in the game, I mean, that's a lot of points scored between these two teams here with so much time left in quarter number one.
There is a lot of time left. And I think, you know, we saw a lot of that last night, too. A lot of points scored in a lot of games. I think that's kind of, you attribute that to the one less scrimmage that teams have. And it's been a few years that that's happened. But I think, you know, teams are taking advantage of that now. And defenses are behind the eight ball a little bit where they don't see as much. They don't get to see as much of their opponents. You know, and there's probably a lot of stuff that comes out here that both of these defenses haven't seen against the offense on film.
So Green Knights jumped out to a 22-0 lead if you're just joining us here on D11Sports.com. By the way, our next game will be a Thursday night matchup. We will be in New Tripoli for Northern Lehigh and Northwestern. It's always a good matchup between those two teams. Last year was a great matchup between those two teams. We'll have that on Thursday night. Number of Thursday night football games this year, obviously with the officiating and, you know, trying to get some other teams in the mix. This won't be fielded at the 19-yard line. And some space up towards the 35. And the Green Knights, again, with good field position to start things off after the run back by Aiden Knorr.
Hey, it looked like Aiden Knorr was just about to get some space, and then it's closed down by Wilson. But again, as you said, on the 40-yard line, real good field position for Penn Argyl's offense to start this drive.
D11Sports.com, thanks Michael R. Globus, financial advisor at Morgan Stanley and Easton, for sponsorship of the game of the week. For all your investment needs, call Michael R. Globus at 610-559-6380. Located at 101 Larry Holmes Drive, Suite 301 in Easton, PA. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC, member SIPC. From the 40. Fake it on the ground. Bruce Miller's going to take it himself, and he pushes up for about 4.5. And we always talk about the development of an athlete, and, you know, where, you know, when you're a freshman, when you're a sophomore, you get in the mix in any sport. You know, they're like, well, he's only a freshman. What is he going to do? She's only a freshman. What's she going to do? And you learn, and you adapt, and, you know, there's repetition, and all of a sudden you're like, you know, Bruce Miller was quarterback, and he was also a receiver. He was going back and forth with a couple of different people, and now all of a sudden he's the guy. Last year, you know, passed for almost 2,000 yards.
Yeah, and we see the maturation of him. We've been able to see it in the last 2 years because we've had their games. But, you know, it's a testament to the coaching staff, the commitment by Brad to get better, and his teammates around him to support him.
They will look to move the chains there. On the carry by Caden Faust.
And if I'm honest here, I think this is what we're going to see from Penn Argyl the rest of the game. You have a 15-point lead. You're in no hurry to do much. I mean, I'd be surprised if they put the ball in the air and do anything other than run out the first quarter here.
And as you say that, you know, you wait for that one time, and maybe they do go. Here's Faust. And Faust turns it up for another 9 yards.
You see a lot of patience, and Faust, a sophomore, showing a lot of patience, and that's what puts him into that starting lineup for Penn Argyl. He just gets behind his blockers, gets behind the offensive line, and just waits for that hole to open up and then shows a burst of speed to pick up some extra yardage.
So picks up 9, ball down to the 41-yard line. A flag thrown in at the end of that play.
It looks like we're going to get holding.
Holding on the offense. Number 56. Ben Arch from the side of the foul. Replay second foul.
So Tominski's first down is brought back all the way towards midfield. A couple good guys in the house, Tom Hausnick, Josh Folk, you know, they're, you know, hanging out, enjoying themselves, getting ready for that big article coming up, the High Valley Live Morning Call, always doing a great job. So the ball at the 49. Second down and 11 is Tominski. Now they'll come back the other way. And almost getting through, but not. A good job defensively as Evan Keat, I believe, was the ball carrier.
That's number 30, Evan Keat on the carry.
And I think we'll see Penn Argyl open up a little bit here on third and long. And I still have to think, you have 2 downs to get first down.
Mm-hmm.
I think in anything over the 45, inside the 45, I think you go for it. Anything less than 5 yards, I think you're in a position where give it a shot.
So So third down and 8. They got to get to the 40-yard line. Didn't see any flags.
Oh, we have a delay game in the back.
Is there? Well, I'll get some of those yards back.
Illegal substitution by the Warriors.
I'm not quite sure. Am I missing somebody?
Third and 3.
I'm missing 2 people.
I'm only counting 10 on Wilson. I don't know how they have 11. They took a guy off, but now I think they only have 10 on the
field.
They
do have 10. I thought they had 9 there for a second. Having 10 is not going to help you.
No.
And no one noticed that one, and straight through, they will move the chains for the first down. And still on his feet, all the way down to about the 31-yard line by the time he stopped. Good run there by Rissmiller. Let's see if they sub someone in and realize that they have only 9 in there. I'm counting 3 times already.
Yeah, I counted 4 before I said anything.
10.
So there's 10 with a guy coming off, so a guy coming back on.
That's
so now
still 10.
Still have 10.
11. There's 11. There's 11, yep.
Nope, now they're taking him back off. Another guy coming off.
There you go.
Still 10, though. Still.
Yeah. Wow. Someone's got to notice that. 22-7. The ball from the 31. Rissmiller goes far side. And he will connect with Alex Moser. And Moser has had a field day today. And down inside a minute remaining here in the first quarter.
Okay, now I think we have 11 on. And he is number 11.
There you go.
All right, so now I think we're good. I mean, that was unfortunate. I think they had 11 on the field when the flag was thrown. Unless it was a substitution that was still on the field when the ball was snapped.
Likely the last play of the first quarter. Second down and 2 from the 23. And Rissmiller takes himself, has the first down, and we'll get down to about the 15-yard line. So it'll be first down and 10 from about the 15.
And I think he was still in bounds.
They'll roll the clock here.
Yep, he was still in bounds, so that'll end the first quarter.
So the quarter will wind down after one quarter here at Alumni Stadium. It's Penn Argyl 22, Wilson 7. You're watching our D11Sports.com Game of the Week presented by St. Luke Sports Medicine.
Do you suffer from nagging neck or back pain? The St. Luke's Comprehensive Spine Program can get you better, faster. We're easy to access and don't require a referral. We'll call you, discuss your symptoms, and put you on a path to healing with the most appropriate provider. Call 1-866-ST-LUKES, option 6, or fill out the online form.
Back here at Alumni Stadium.
Was there a timeout called?
That's it looks like.
I could think of. It had to be a timeout by Wilson, I think.
So timeout was called, so we'll keep it right here. And it's taken by Moser. And Moser.
And that should do it for the quarter.
All right, so there's an extra play there, but we'll keep it right here. And it'll be 22-7, still after 1.
Will be first and 10, Penn Argyl.
For over 175 years, New York Life has been helping families and businesses with their life, disability, and long-term care planning needs. Whether you have current coverage in place or in need of reviewing your options, please contact their office in Allentown to find the right plan to fit your needs. Call New York Life at 610-616-4430 today. This quarter brought to you by JFR Salvage, the full-service scrap metal recycling company serving the Lehigh Valley for nearly 50 years. JFR Salvage will pay you cash for all grades of scrap metal, including iron, steel, copper, brass, aluminum, stainless, and junk vehicles. Competitive pricing and superior service are just a few reasons you choose JFR Salvage for your scrap metal needs. Please visit their website at jfrsalvage.com or one of their locations at Wingap or East Stroudsburg. Anthony Graziani, who played here at Penn Argyl, in charge there at JFR Salvage, obviously a standout at Lehigh University as well. Remember, if you're a student from any District 11 school interested in broadcasting, journalism, or photography, check out d11sports.com. Follow your dream. Get close to the action. Just take part in our student internship program. For more information, contact your athletic director or reach out to myself or Dave at d11sports.com. Matt, 22-7. Your thoughts of the first quarter?
It was a long first quarter, actually.
Mm-hmm.
You have the opening kickoff, then you have a couple big plays by Penn Argyl then as well. The nice drive by Wilson, the long touchdown by Wilson. The offense for Wilson, I think, just needs more consistency. Penn Argyl's been able to do what they want on offense and just control the clock and remain consistent. But Wilson needs to develop that consistency, and I think it's going to start with their offensive line.
So first and goal from the 8, and easy touchdown coming 3.
That was
so 8 yards for Faust.
Showing great patience. Just waited for his blockers to get where they needed to be, and then just waited for the opening to the outside and went. Take another look. Caden Faust in the backfield. He gets the direct snap. Gets up in there, waits, has his lead blocker, number 40, Gavin Cunningham. It just allows him an opportunity to get in there and engage his blocker to open up that space to the sideline.
So the Green Knights waste no time on the first play. So they score on the first play of the game, the first play of the second quarter. Extra point by Larry Ladro is good. It is 29-7. In favor of the Green Knights. So, recapping the scoring, an 81-yard touchdown via kickoff return by Alex Moser. 2-point conversion by Caden Faust made it 8-0. Then they stopped Wilson drive down to the 15-yard line. Ended up being a 90-yard Brad Rismiller to Alex Moser touchdown pass to make it 15-0. 15-yard touchdown run from Penn Argyl's Damian Tominski made it 22-0. Then the 63-yard touchdown pass from Jeremy Kressman to Rodney Bronson, who got through the defense and went down the sideline. And then Caden Faust here in the first play of the second quarter scores from 8 yards out to make it 29-7 in favor of the Green Knights. So glad you could join us here on this Saturday afternoon up out here on the hill. Al DiCarlo, Matt Avancho. Chase Eller is roaming the sidelines, one of our student reporters from Wilson area. Doing a great job for us since coming on board this time last year, actually.
Yes, exactly.
This one's going to stay play. It is going to be picked up at the 4-yard line. I'm not sure. Bronson thought maybe it was going to go into the end zone. It did not. Ends up getting taken down right around the 10-yard line.
I thought Bronson thought he had a lot of time where he could pick it up and make something happen. Unfortunately, the Penn Argyl kickoff team did a nice job staying in their lanes and not giving him anywhere to go.
Next week for the Warriors to host Palisades, and for Penn Argyl, they will have Mahanoy area before hitting the road at Northern Lehigh and then get Northwestern in a couple of weeks. So 9 seconds into quarter number 2. Kressman going to throw, and the reception made there by Bronson.
Kressman to Bronson.
So if you're Wilson, the middle part of the field has been open for you, whether it's running by Cressman or just, you know, the reception. But like you said, they have themselves a big hole here.
They do, and they have to get the ball out quick. That time Cressman, he's able to take one, two, three steps, gets the ball out. You neutralize that defensive line when you do that.
So a pickup of 7, the ball at the 16. Cressman going to come near side this time. That's Days. Days will jump across the 20 up towards the 21-yard line. Still a couple yards short of that first down marker.
But two quick plays, two quick passes. Now you put yourself in third and short. Definitely a manageable. You still have the same distance that you've been completing the first two plays.
Third down and 2. We haven't seen him run. Now he's going to be taken all the way back to the 1 yard line.
And that was an opportunity. Cressman, he had his running back outside, but he wasn't able to see him to get him to dump the ball off to him as that pass rush was coming. But like, there you get a chance when it takes longer than those quick throws. The offensive line is not able to hold out this pass rush of the Penn Argyl Green Knights.
Yeah, they mark it at the 4, so now you're going to be punting from the back of your end zone. Is that Fekete back there?
Yes. Well, you remember we almost got hit by one of his punts.
Yes, we did. A couple occasions. So here's Fekete with Tominski waiting at the 38-yard line. And this is going to be right at Tominski. Fielded from the 39. Tominski makes one move, gets inside the 20, on the sideline, still on his feet, and it'll be down to about the 11-yard line. So good start here for Penn Argyl, as they still have 10 minutes to work with here in the first half and have themselves a big lead.
You credit Evan Keat, number 30 for Penn Argyl. He has a nice block on there on Wilson's gunner on the perimeter to give Tominski the opportunity to catch it, run 10 to 15 yards before engaging in any of the Wilson Warrior punt team.
Only touchdown for Wilson today was a 63-yard touchdown pass from Cressman to Rodney Bronson. But it's the Green Knights right now trying to put this game really away here early. But despite the score, it's a really long game.
It has
been
a long game, you're right.
So start things from the 11. Here's Tominski. Tominski gets a good block in front, and Tominski will walk into the end zone from 11 yards.
I could say the same thing I just said about Caden Faust on the previous touchdown. When we get a chance to look at that replay, you'll see Tominski. It looks like he's just jogging.
Yep.
It's not like he's not like running full speed, but he doesn't need to. He's waiting for his blockers to engage, letting them get onto the perimeter, get lock up, make the defender make a decision, and then he makes them wrong by going the other way. So Tominski, Caden Faust doing a great job from the backfield for Penn Argyl.
So the extra point is good. 36-7 in favor of Penn Argyl. I want to thank Culligan Water for jumping on board. Culligan Water asks, when is the last time you had your water tested? Get a free in-home water assessment from Reynolds Culligan. Visit yourwater.net for more information. Culligan Water, had them since 1999. Fantastic. They come out when you need it. They take care of your water. Give them a shout there at yourwater.net for more information. Matt, looking at this here, and a lot of people thought maybe this would be this kind of score. Not maybe this kind of score, but a little lopsided in favor of Penn Argyl, but not this early.
No, I don't think so this early. The key is going to be, what does Wilson do coming back? They have to continue. Coach emphatically said about how the camp, they've always been competing. They're competing. Every one of them, you know, they have the right attitude. They have to come back, and they just have to continue to play. They can't give in because of what the score says. They have to finish the game.
Got a flag on a play.
Looks like we're going to have all sides on the kickoff team. We're seeing everything today.
So they'll bring this one back. Not really looking forward to the game on Thursday night between Northwestern and Northern Lehigh. Northern Lehigh, as you mentioned, losing to Catasauqua, and Northwestern, you know, just expecting another big year for them, you know, doing it to Maka pretty easily.
And I think, again, as I said, the Catasauqua-Northern Lehigh game, I think that's not indicative of what Northern Lehigh is. I think they're better than that. It's just they came up and they draw the straw of Catasauqua opening night, who has a lot of talent at the skilled positions.
Here's Days across the 25 up towards the 30, and a good run back across the 35 towards about the 37, 38-yard line. And we'll see the offense come back on the field for Wilson.
Brought down by number 25,
is it all passing attack now, or just a drive attack for right now?
I think it has to be a drive attack. We haven't seen the ball get to Ian Fekete very much. They haven't had much success with the running game. I think they need to continue with those short passes. Continue with short 5-yard passes. Get the ball out of Cressman's hands quickly.
So Cressman from his own 38, and the ball is fumbled on the ground. A lot of green there. And it is the Green Knights that come out of the pile.
It looks like it's 54, Cale Grimm. It looks like Fields comes up limping for Wilson. We hope he's okay. They can't afford to lose him at the linebacker spot as well after already losing Ze'Andre Johnson prior to the game.
So a big turnover with 9:33 on the clock here. The ball right around the 37-yard line. And they'll float this one across. And that's Faust. And Faust obviously wants to stay inbounds.
Looks like his progress was stopped inbounds, but a good sign for Wilson as Fields is he's the one able to get over there and make the tackle, so it looks like he's okay.
He picks up a Penn Argyl. First down.
See how fast Coach Mutton decides to go.
First down pickup. From the 20. Thinking one way, going the other way to Tominski. Tominski still on his feet, dives forward, and there's a flag at the end of that play.
I wonder if we're going to get a blindside block by the offensive lineman.
It was close.
And I think that's what they're going to call. It was close. Unfortunately, the official sees the back of it and sees the worst part of it.
We're still right around 9 minutes left in the first half of play. It's 36-7. And the only positive here, the ball moved back to the 40 as Wilson trying to avoid this one from going in. This is a huge, huge defensive position that the Warriors are in. Tominski takes the handoff. And he'll gain about 5 or 6 of those yards back. The first down marker is all the way down to about the 15-yard line.
And that time, Tominski, I think, could have afforded to be a little bit more patient. He didn't let the blocker kind of get position, and he was going full speed. But if he gives this guy a little bit more time, I think he would have picked up more yardage. I think if you're Penn Argyl, you're going for it completely the whole way. Second down, you're trying to get some yards. Third down, get a little bit closer. Go for it on fourth.
Second down and 19. I agree with that, by the way. Rhys Miller, and great job defensively. A lot of white jerseys coming there and making a play, including Jason Johnson.
At that time, just Rhys Miller held on to it a little bit too long, and that pass rush got there. Looks like we're going to have a timeout, Penn Argyl.
Timeout brought to you by Culligan Water. Culligan Water asks, when is the last time you had your water tested to get a free in-home water assessment from Reynolds? Culligan, visit yourwater.net for more information. Yourwater.net for more information, Culligan Water Company. So glad you could join us here on this Saturday afternoon. For over 175 years, New York Life has been helping families and businesses with their life, disability, and long-term care planning needs. Whether you have a current coverage in place or in need of reviewing your options, please contact their office in Allentown to find the right place, plan to fit your needs. Call New York Life at 610-616-4430 today. So if you are the Green Knights right now, again, still 7:24, but you almost put yourself a touchdown, technically we'll put that mercy rule in effect at the start of the third quarter if it stays that way.
Mm-hmm. And now I'm not quite sure what you do. You know, you're third and over 20, third and 24. I mean, I still think, depending on how much you get, if you're 10 less than 10 yards for a first down, I think you go for it. If you're over 10, I think it depends. I think between 10 and 15, that's kind of a tough one, tough decision.
So third down and 25. Rhys Miller waiting, nothing there. Now looking for Tominski, and Tominski with a one-handed catch right at the 20-yard line. Thought that was overthrown for a while, and he went right up and brought that one down. Damian Tominski, that's why everyone's talking about him. Take a look.
Listen, and all I'm going to say here is this is nothing against the coaching staffs, nothing against – this is not coaching. This is not scheme. This is – Rhys Miller was looking for Tominski the whole time. He got to a spot, and he went up and made an athletic play, a great athletic play with the one-handed catch, and puts him fourth and five. Now, yeah, you go for it.
Wow, what a catch. 6:50 on the clock and counting.
No. And there's your
they
first down.
They got the first down. I was going to say, they just got it. Remember, they needed 25 to get that first down. They little by little got it. It helps with a one-handed catch and the penalty.
Yeah, 20-yard one-handed catch by Tominski and a 5-yard offsides. It makes it picking up that 25 yards easy.
Rhys Miller going to take it himself. I guess down to about the 10.
And as I said earlier, I think now you start to see Coach Mutton in the offense at Green Penn Argyl take a little bit of more time, kind of just run the clock as they're trying to get this last scoring drive of the half. I mean, 6 minutes is still a long time, but you could easily, I think, in these 10 yards, you could run off 4 minutes almost.
From the 10. Direct snap again, and they're not going to run off 4 minutes.
No.
Because you're going to get another Faust touchdown.
And he's very impressive, Caden Faust, right now, early in his sophomore career. Shields up!
So after Tominski one-handed catch, Faust takes it in from, I believe it was 10.
10 yards.
It comes at the 5:43 mark. And the extra point is good to make it 43-7.
The extra point is good with 5 minutes, 43 seconds left in the half. Big 4-3.
And Matt, you are Wilson right now. You have one goal. Score some points. You have to.
You have to. But I think you just have to get something.
A good drive, yeah.
You need to get something going as a group. as we saw that first drive, it was a lot of Jeremy Cressman. Long pass play by Rodney Bronson. And if you couple, like, bring those together, bring the scrambling ability of Cressman, the big play ability of Bronson, we have yet to see Fekete get a pass thrown his way, really, that gets past the line of scrimmage. But they have to get something going to build confidence, because that's going to be the biggest thing. Coming off that 0-10 campaign last year, you know, these kids, and Coach Bergstrass talked about it, he had to get in there and talk to them and motivate them that you can be successful. He has to get back to that and just take little steps, set little goals in this game, and just focus on that. And that's going to be a tough way to do it.
Wow. They go for the onside kick. I didn't think anybody was playing up. Go for the onside kick, and they end up getting the ball back.
Well, that's been a couple kickoffs in a row where they've left the – they basically haven't had anybody between the two hashes.
Yep. You're right. So 5:43 on the clock. Penn Argyl gets the ball back again.
And I'd be willing to bet in the second half we don't see many of Penn Argyl's starters.
Mm-hmm. On the ground. And Fekete comes in hard. As the Simpson.
That was one of only a few plays so far today that goes negative yards for Penn Argyl.
It's interesting when we look at their schedule. I mean, they have Northern Lehigh and Northwestern Caddy three in a row after next week. You know, might as well a good football team as well. So, they're, you know, that middle part of their schedule is going to be really rough. But, you know, I don't care. Every week's going to be tough. I think where we've been looking at a number of teams getting better and starters back for a number of teams as well. Riss Miller, and he doesn't get any yards there.
Now, as you said, again, I think for Coach Mutton, you look to continue to polish in this game. You're up big right now, still in the first half, but you look to polish, but you can't help but look ahead a little bit. Okay, what can we do to work for next week? And I think that after those two, you have to think those two games. Now, you see Northern Lehigh, Northwestern, Catasauqua. That's a three-game stretch that you're preparing for. You were preparing for them all along.
Third down and 12, and they get that one across, and they get Moser, and Moser right through the middle of the field, and Moser down to the 10-5, touchdown.
Yep. And that play was off third and long.
To Moser, one more time, to the house, shields up.
So Riss Miller to Moser, 50 yards.
Real good play call by Penn Argyl. They have the blitz. Wilson dials up the blitz. They're trying to get home, trying to get that pass rush, put pressure on Riss Miller. They were able to have success last drive for the most part, trying to get to him. But unfortunately, Penn Argyl has the screenplay called at that very time. You'll see here, they're all coming up the field. He's able to find Moser coming in. Moser picks up a good block downfield by his lineman, another one by the running back, and he's able to take it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
That comes with 4:10 on the clock for Penn Argyl. There's a flag on the play.
Looks to go against Penn Argyl now.
That one is no good.
Lerdo's kick is no good. With 4:10 left in the half, score is Penn Argyl 49.
It's funny when people start looking at the score and they say 49-7. They go, oh, touchdowns. They don't know it was 8-0 to start, an extra point
exactly,
later.
Exactly, yes. You had one 2-point conversion off a penalty, and then you lose a point off a penalty. Yes, the rest of the
Today's game brought to you by Michael R. Glovis, financial advisor at Morgan Stanley, located at 101 Larry Holmes Drive, Suite 301 in Easton, PA. For all your investment needs, call Michael R. Glovis, 610-559-6380. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC, member SIPC. I want to thank Tim Egan, the fine athletic director, for his hospitality up here. And, you know, new scoreboard, new track, as we mentioned. And right now, still a ways away from the first half ending.
Yeah, we're still a ways away. 4:10 left. But you're still seeing Wilson up front. The front line of the kickoff return still spread wide open. Now you have somebody walking up.
Oh, you're not going to do it again. It's been fielded at the 18. Man, Wilson at 4 minutes on the clock.
Now, we were talking last time about how Wilson needs to come out and get something going consistently and build some cohesion, but unfortunately, with the onside kick, they didn't have an opportunity to offensively. So at this point, the coaching staff has to think, okay, what can we do to set these little goals to help us be successful and start building a little bit of confidence?
Oh, someone moved. You know the best name on the field is, right? And I'll get to that in a second. Looking to throw. That one just aired up and incomplete. You know, you look at, you know, we have, you know, Braden Crescenapera, who, you know, that's a tough name sometimes, tough name, but I'm going to spell it to everybody at home, let them ponder it, and then they can, you know, decide how to say it. Jacob, and then spell this way, P-I-E-T-R-A-S-Z-K-I-E-W-I-C-Z. Z. Every letter in the alphabet, all 26 in that name, by the way. All right, they're not all in, but okay, I thought they were. Pass play, and that one is complete to the far side of the field, and a great job by Marcel Days, still on his feet. And Days with a big play inside the 47-yard line.
And again, you see when they have time and they're able to get the ball out to their receivers, Wilson and the receivers have been able to make that first guy miss. And here, Day does a nice job of making that first guy miss, breaks the tackle there, and then breaks a few more to grab extra yardage.
So the ball to 46. Days gets this one and tries to get to the near side and gets out of bounds right around the 39-yard line, right around the 40.
We have a flag on the play. We have a legal shift on Wilson.
So the ball will be back at around the 49-yard line. I know people at home still waiting for that name. Just relax. I'll get back to it. Hand out to Fields, and Fields nowhere to go. And I have a moment here. I'm going to give it to you one more time. Okay, I'm going to give it to you one more time. Okay.
And as you said there, Fields, Penn Argyl coming in groves, just getting there to help bring him down. He's a big kid, runs hard. You need multiple defenders to bring him down.
I can't do it now. There's
Dude,
a lot
not
of letters.
Time.
There's a lot of letters there. I need 30 seconds. Second and 7 from the 49. Gets hit as he throws. That one incomplete. Again, was looking downfield for Days. All right, so Jacob's last name is P-I-E-T-R-A-A-S-Z-K-I-E-W-I-C-Z. And when you look at it, you're like, okay. But it's not as hard as you think.
No.
Pietrakowicz. What's so hard about it? Why are you complaining?
I want to say Pietrakowicz.
Oh, there's a lot you could say there. I couldn't figure it out. I had my kids trying it. They looked at the name and they said, forget it, Dad. I'm out. incomplete. Had a receiver, but a little bit too far off his side to Bronson. That'll bring up fourth down.
And looks like Wilson continuing to go for it on fourth down, not going to punt.
So fourth down and 13. Cressman's going to try to get some of that. He'll get a bunch of it back, but it will be given back up to Penn Argyle.
That was a good job by the defense. They weren't committing too much to him. They only rushed there four, expecting Cressman to break out and scramble as they drop their seven in coverage, and then they just enclose on him to make the short tackle before he can pick up the first down.
You got your red ticket?
I got my red ticket.
Okay.
I'm ready to go.
By the way, that Mega Millions, that was $1.2 billion or whatever it was.
You missed it by one number?
No, by five and the number.
And the extra in the Powerball.
From the 41. They'll pitch this one back. And again, about, 13 and a half, 14 yards. So a good start there. I think you're going to see a lot of Faust all year long. Again, he gets those kind of holes from that line. It's going to, some positive stuff for him.
It also depends on how they want to utilize him. We talked earlier about the flexibility that Coach Mutton has with these skill position players for Penn Argyle. He can put Faust in a lot of different positions. He's been at the quarterback spot a little bit.
Ball from the 46.
And they're just waiting for the clock.
Not much there on that handoff.
Looks like a little confusion in the backfield. Wrist mill turned one way. The fullback goes another for that quick play. We called Gavin Cunningham's name a bunch of times blocking for these other guys. Nice of them to give him a carry. Let him touch the ball a little bit.
So second down and 9 from the 45. Minute left on the clock. And they'll pitch this one back. And Faust all the way down to about the 30-yard line.
I think they'll have to run one more play. Depending on how quickly they set this.
-7 is your score. He's going to wait as far down as he can. And pitch it one more time. The flag as the official goes down as well.
Oh, he got hit hard too.
Yes, he did. Oh, he's good. It looks like he's okay. Tell you what, there's nothing to joke about when we say that. I remember I used to cover the Eagles back in the day, and quick story. Yuki Washington from Channel 3, I think, saved my life. I was standing on a pylon in the end zone like a dummy, not paying attention. They pitched the ball across and almost came sliding down. He picked me up and threw me down. As fast as he almost saved me, almost killed me because, the Fox Sports truck came,
yeah.
Come down, almost took my head off. But you get taken down like that, not knowing, that's tough.
No,
at least he'll get
credit.
The half. Yeah, at least he'll get the half.
Credit the official. He pops back up. He had his eyes on the flag. He was throwing the penalty for the holding call. and didn't see the guys coming in right behind him. Looks like their penalty is just going to let the clock run out in a half.
So, winds down the clock, 49-7. And we'll wait here for Chase Eller, who has Brady Mutton down on the field. Chase is down there, and we go down to Chase.
All right, Coach, it was a great first half. What are your thoughts about it?
We just came out and executed. That was nice to see. We had a couple problems, mistakes the first couple drives, but once we figured it out, we can obviously see we were focused and ready to go.
I saw some flags out there, some things like that. That's been about all. What do you have to say about that?
That's week one. Everyone's going to make some mistakes. That goes along with it. We cleaned it up. We talked to them already, but that's week one. Things are going to happen. We got to bounce back each time we do it.
All right. Thank you, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
All right, Chase, thanks a lot, and thanks to Brady Mutton. We're at the half. It's all Penn Argyl. It's 49-7. You're watching our D11Sports.com Game of the Week, presented by St. Luke's Sports Medicine. Back after this.
St. Luke's knows that trust is the foundation of all relationships. It's earned over time. It's the type of relationship you should have with your healthcare team. While our healthcare needs are different, one thing is constant. St. Luke's is focused on building a lasting relationship with you, earning your trust and putting your well-being first. When it comes to great healthcare, trust is essential. St. Luke's, the care you trust, now more than ever. Do you suffer from nagging neck or back pain? The St. Luke's Comprehensive Spine Program can get you better, faster. We're easy to access and don't require a referral. We'll call you, discuss your symptoms, and put you on a path to healing with the most appropriate provider. Call 1-866-ST-LUKES, option 6, or fill out the online form.
Interested in a medical career? Consider St. Luke's if you want to be a doctor or a nurse. Based in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, we are the area's only four-year medical school and the largest provider of medical residencies and fellowships, and the country's longest-running school of nursing. Train at an organization that is nationally recognized in education, patient care, and quality. See why we are ranked the nation's number one teaching hospital. Where you train matters. The best doctors and nurses train at the best hospitals. St. Luke's University Health Network.
We are back here at Alumni Stadium. Al DeCarlo, Matt Avancher, Chase Eller, Sean Riley, Sports Fan Base Network. Hope you're enjoying our game here on D11Sports.com, our game of the week presented by St. Luke's Sports Medicine. It's been all Penn Argyl here as they, and we are only at halftime. It's 49-7. And we'll give you the scoring recap. 81-yard touchdown, a kickoff return by Alex Moser, a two-point conversion by Faust made it 8-0. A 90-yard touchdown from Brad Rissmiller to Alex Moser made it 15-0. Then a 15-yard touchdown run, Penn Argyl's Damian Tominski made it 22-0. A 63-yard touchdown from Cressman to Rodney Bronson, only score of the game, cut into the lead, made it 22-7. But moments later, Caden Faust's first play of the second quarter, 8-yard touchdown run, made 29-7. Then an 11-yard touchdown run by Damian Tominski made it 36-7. Kyle Grimm, fumble recovery to Wilson, 37. Damian Tominski made a great one-handed catch. Caden Faust then took it in from 10 yards, made it 43-7. And then Riss Miller to Alex Moser, 50 yards, 49-7. The extra point was no good. Alex Moser having himself a great day. The 81-yard kickoff return, the 90-yard reception, and also for him a 50-yard reception as well. With that, we go down and listen into the Wilson area marching band. Thank you.
last sign.
Presenting their 2023 field production. Technicolor Dream, put your hands together for the Wilson Warrior Marching Band.
St. Luke's and our coaches are going to provide the safest and most comprehensive training environment that a student athlete would want. Hopefully they come to us and they leave and there's not another need to be filled. Your daughter or son's team can come to us and we provide it all.
On the ground, go!
The team atmosphere and the team that we have put together of sport performance coaches and athletic trainers is why parents should choose St. Luke's University Health Network for their sport performance needs.
There's not another orthopedic group, sports medicine group, healthcare system in the country that has high level, degree certified, years of experience.
Bench, hip thrust, or floor, we know what block A is, and then let me get another group of
certified athletic trainers and the performance coaches are assigned to schools, and they are there, and they are getting the teams and doing team training around sports schedules and the student activity schedules. That's primarily where it's done. We also provide training here, like at this facility. We provide a comprehensive training program that is the most up-to-date training advancements. It's the safest it can be.
We got our AWOCs, remember, good.
It's not about gimmicks. Our guys are all educated and have the science behind what they're doing, a rhyme or reason to what they're doing. And we have leadership that will make sure that we're going to provide the best service there is. We actually care about your kids.
Focusing on getting my butt back and my chest up.
People don't know how to use this stuff. And so you need someone to teach them and to help them navigate it in a way that's going to be productive, that's not going to hurt them.
They trust me to put together a workout, and they're always asking questions about it, which is great. You know, I wanted them to have that trust that, you know, I'm going to help them succeed on and off the court.
Every coach, every parent, they want what's best for their student. Okay? They want what's going to help them be the best version of themselves. And so that's what we can provide. I don't think there's anything in this area that can rival it.
We are at the half.
We are at the half. 49-7 is your score. Penn Argyl leading Wilson. It's our D11Sports.com Game of the Week presented by St. Luke Sports Medicine. So glad you could join us here on this afternoon. And this one got away from Wilson quickly. And we'll see how they respond in the second half. As, you know, Matt and I have spoke about, you know, you put yourself in a position where, you know, you build for next week. And that's what you want to do is build for next week. And we'll see what happens there. St. Luke's the region's largest sports medicine provider, covering more than 200,000 student enrollment and 40,000 student athletes in Pennsylvania and New Jersey, covering 8 counties and providing the most comprehensive and advanced treatment for athletic injuries. St. Luke's offers athletic training, orthopedic care, physical therapy, and concussion management, plus sports performance training for individual athletes and teams. During these extraordinary times, you can trust St. Luke's Sports Medicine to provide extraordinary care. Culligan Water asks, when is the last time you had your water tested? Get a free in-home water assessment from Reynolds Culligan. Visit yourwater.net for more information. Culligan Water, yourwater.net for more information. For over 175 years, New York Life has been helping families and businesses with their life, disability, and long-term care planning needs. Whether you have a current coverage in place or in need of reviewing your options, please contact their office in Allentown to find the right plan to fit your needs. Call New York Life at 610-616-4430 today. If you're a student from any District 11 school, interested in broadcasting, journalism, or photography, check out d11sports.com. Follow your dream, get close to the action, and take part in our student internship program. For more information, contact your athletic director or reach out to myself or Dave at d11sports.com. Support for d11sports.com Game of the Week comes from Michael R. Glovis, financial advisor at Morgan Stanley in Easton. For all your investment needs, call Michael R. Glovis at 610-559-6380, located at 101 Larry Holmes Drive, Suite 301 in Easton, PA. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC, member SIPC. So get ready for this third quarter to get underway. Both teams to make their field this quarter. Is brought to you by JFR Salvage, the full-service scrap metal recycling company serving the Lehigh Valley for nearly 50 years. JFR Salvage will pay you cash for all grades of scrap metal, including iron, steel, copper, brass, aluminum, stainless, and junk vehicles. Competitive pricing and superior service are just a few reasons why you choose JFR Salvage for your scrap metal needs. Please visit their website at jfrsalvage.com or one of their locations in Wingap or East Stroudsburg. And so glad you could join us here on a Saturday afternoon. We'll get right back in the action on Thursday, and we'll go to New Tripoli for a good matchup between Northern Lehigh and Northwestern. Matt, before we even – well, let's go ahead before and then come back to this game. Your thoughts of that matchup, Northwestern with a big win of Tamaqua and Northern Lehigh losing to Catasauqua in a game that went back and forth, but then Catasauqua really ran away with it.
I think we're going to see a Northern Lehigh come out with a little bit more fire on Thursday night. You know, that's always a rivalry, and those teams play well against each other. But again, Northwestern coach Snyder does a great job there, and he's done it for years. Ever since he started, it's been fantastic the way he's run his program. I'm always excited to watch them play. Always excited to see what he does and how he's very creative offensively to see, you know, what new twists he's going to put on their offense and to be successful. He always seems to get the one thing he does that I really like. He always seems to put his players in positions to be successful. You know, not to discount Northern Lehigh, Coach Tout does the same thing. I just think Northwestern has a little bit more than Northern Lehigh does this year.
As far as this game is concerned, Wilson back onto the field. We're waiting for Penn Argyl to take the field. This one got away quick. I mean, you're talking about 12 seconds in and 81 yards for a touchdown, you're down 8-0.
Yeah, it did. But Wilson responded. Credit to Wilson. They responded back with a nice drive of their own to start the game. A lot of Jeremy Cressman scrambling, just not able to put it away once they got down to the 10-yard line. Penn Argyl was able to stuff them. I think Coach Bergstresser and his staff, they just need to worry about getting consistent, try to build something, try to get that confidence going. All they should have been all in the locker room just talking about, okay, guys, listen, the first 24 minutes did not go the way we wanted it to go. You know, but we're facing a quality team. These next 24 minutes, we need to just go out, do our jobs, execute, and compete. That's all we're looking for. And if you can't do that, we're going to find somebody else who's going to go out, execute, and compete. And like he said before the game, he said jobs were up in the air, jobs were open. I think they are even more now as well.
Well, as both teams make their way onto the field, the Wilson Warriors, they will host Palisades next week, then at Saucon Valley, at Lehigh. They'll get Bangor at home, at Southern Lehigh, Blue Mountain at home, at Pottsville, Northwestern, and Notre Dame. You look at Wilson's schedule. That is, I mean, for how where they are now with, again, not that much depth right there, and you're looking at their schedule, they have a really, really tough schedule.
I think they do. When you compare those two schedules together, not to discredit what Penn Argyl has to go against, you know, I think it's just top to bottom, you know, Wilson's schedule looks a little bit more daunting than Penn Argyl's as it is. And it's like it's maybe not every week, but every other week they're facing a quality opponent.
No question. For Penn Argyl Green Knights, they will be at home once again here at Alumni Field. Alumni Stadium, Mahanoy area, then on the road in Slayton and Northern Lehigh. They'll get Northwestern here on the Hill on the 16th of September. At Catasauqua on a Friday night, then at Minersville, back-to-back road games, Palisades here at home, Schuylkill Haven at home, and then finish the season both on the road at Panther Valley and then at their arch rivals in Bangor. So Wilson gets the ball first here in the second half.
For the Word of the Warriors, number one, Marcel Hayes. Number 13, Ryan Bronson. Doing the for the Green Bangs, number 22.
So again, the mercy rule will go into effect, Matt, right after this kickoff. But you look at the first half, again, this game started at 2:30. It's already 4 if you're watching us live. So it was a long first half, if you think about it.
It was very long first half.
Second half underway from Alumni Stadium. This one picked up at the 21-yard line. And taking that one is Bronson. And Bronson has the space, still on his feet, and gets across the 45, down to about the 44-yard line or so, depending on where they mark this one. And a good start there for the Warriors.
And it hasn't been lack of field position for the Warrior offense. They've had great field position, nothing like this. This is a great way to start the second half. It's just putting it together and getting it moving down the field. That we'll see what adjustments they've made at halftime and how they come out and hope to attack this Penn Argyl defense.
So from the 45, that's where they're going to mark it for Jeremy Cressman. Cressman goes up top, has a receiver. It's Fekete, and Fekete comes down with it and still moving downfield. You mentioned him. We had not called his name really all day. They tried to go in the back of the end zone earlier, and it was incomplete, but that's a good start for the Warriors.
That is, and it was a good one-on-one play. It was a 50-50 ball. Fekete does the job of getting in position over the D-back. Cressman puts it in a position where he can go up and make a play. But you have to credit Fekete with making a smart play of positioning himself inside the defender.
Taken by himself is Cressman, and Cressman goes in for the touchdown. So a 9-yard touchdown run by Cressman, and Wilson with a good start.
And that's how you want to see them respond to the second half, come out and play and just compete, like, and get the ball down the field, which they did. Two plays, one play to Fekete. Cressman keeps the ball on his own, and they get into the end zone. You have a lot of blocking out in front for him. Fekete out there, Day. Freshman William Sains, 55, making a block for him as well. Not quite sure what happened here. Oh, they had too many guys on the field again.
Yep. So they'll move him back 5 yards. And it still is good. So the Warriors come out on the first drive, a couple plays to cut the lead to 49-14.
Extra point is good. With 10 minutes, 31 seconds left in the third quarter. Score is penalty.
Well, if you're coach, Burstresser, you got to be pleased how they came out. You come out of the locker room, you're down big, you're talking to your players, and they came out with a little spunk, a little fire.
Yeah, they came out with some fire. They came out and made some things happen in those two plays. It's just, now can we continue? Can they build more off of that and continue to just improve little step, one step at a time?
And this year, besides the Saturday game, we have a bunch of Friday night games. We also have a couple Saturday games and a couple Thursday games. So we give you Thursday, Friday, and Saturday get you in the mix. I want to thank Sean Riley, Sports Fan Base Network, and their team. Always doing a great job with us here on D11Sports.com. That one picked up by Riss Miller. You go back in the day when Paul Reduzzi was the head coach and, you know, Roy Cortez was here, and they had that team that was, you know, really good.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember that, you know, and I talked to a lot of people about this. You know, when you have second players that are, you know, backups, whatever, in those days, Penn Arnold was winning the games at halftime, 35-0, 40-0 at halftime. So a lot of the backup players were playing a full half. By the
Correct.
Time they were done, they were playing eight, you know, like four full games of, you know, as a freshman, as a sophomore. That's a lot of experience you get out of that.
And that's a fantastic thing to be able to do. You see here, you know, this is the backup offense in for Penn Arnold. They have their starters out. Being able to get these guys meaningful game reps to see what they're capable of doing.
That was Jaden Hunter on the carry, sophomore.
And like before, I don't think we'll see Penn Arnold go in any kind of hurry.
So third quarter action, 49-14. I keep, you know, looking over at that scoreboard, not at the score, but just the size of that scoreboard to what it used to be here.
Yeah, that score is nice. The scoreboard is fantastic.
Speaking of scoreboard, we've changed our scoreboard as well here on D11.
And that quarterback for Penn Arnold is Mason Sues, a sophomore. We talked about him earlier. He plays wide receiver, moves around a lot. One of those guys that can be flexible for Coach Button and do a lot of different things where it doesn't have to always be Riss Miller in the backfield being the one throwing the ball around.
So first down, the ball at the 43-yard line for Sues. And that one comes near side. Pass completion. Evan Johnson, the sophomore. Oh, excuse me. That was A.J. Sora. Looked like a seven from up here.
Yeah, shocked to see Penn Arnold put the ball in the air, but I do like that. Credit Coach Button allowing the second group just to play the game plan. You have the score in hand. You have it the way you want it. It doesn't mean you change the game plan and just run the ball. Let your players go out and execute what you put in all week.
On the ground once again. And a good tackle by Deshaun Simpson on Jaden Hunter. You know, Matt, that said, the way you're saying, obviously, you're short here of the first down marker, but, you know, you're not changing it, but, you know, the clock's still running regardless, so it's in. Even if there's an incompletion, that clock still runs. So it kind of makes you keep doing what you're doing.
Correct.
Makes
and
more
I
sense.
I think a lot of times, though, you see people, they think, all right, so we're up. We're mercy rules in effect. Just run the ball. Just run the ball. But like you said, the clock is running. Just continue to execute your offense. Don't worry about changing anything up.
And what a lot of people sometimes don't understand, too, is the kids that are on the field right now are getting an opportunity. They may have not even seen the field before. And, you know, they want to prove something to their coaches and to themselves.
Exactly. They want to get out there and make Sues. A name for themselves, like Mason right now.
Sues gets across the 40 down to about the 38-yard line for the first down.
And one of the guys making a name for himself, he'll show up on the film, is number 84, Jack McLaughlin, a junior tight end. He comes down, and he's the one who sets the edge with a de-cleating block from his slot position on the outside linebacker.
Third quarter clock winding down to 6 minutes. After an opening drive, start the third quarter by Wilson. This is Penn Arnold's first drive of the third quarter. Quick toss play to Zachary Metzger. And Metzger moves upfield, gains an extra 3 yards or so.
This is going to be good for Mason Sues also to develop confidence in throwing the ball in a varsity game. You know, as a sophomore, you know, probably just had JV opportunities last year to throw the ball and play quarterback. Now he may have to come into meaningful time at different points in this season if something happens to Riss Miller, or just to give the Penn Argyl Green Knights something else, another option in the backfield.
So second down, first down marker inside the 30, right around the 28-yard line. Back on the ground, and quickly in on the play was Makai Fields.
Yeah, that time Makai Fields just read the play. He was reading that back coming across, and he shoots through the backside gap, able to get to him in the backfield for the big loss.
Third down and 11. You got three receivers on the far side. Sues takes the low snap. Yeah, really good job here by Wilson. Their defense, you know, and I think we always say it, and I think Coach said it, was that he doesn't want them to quit. He wants them to play every play. And, you know, you say that a lot. You can't quit. You got to keep playing because every play is a new play.
Exactly. It's not like Wilson has the starters out there against backups. They have a lot of their starters, but they're also shuffling in some other guys at different positions. Again, he said every job is open. And I think after that first half, their coaching staff probably looking to see, all right, who else can we put in here and make something happen?
Sues takes the block in front, now gets to the outside. Could be dangerous. And good job of the Warriors to come back. And this is going to be right
That's
on that
be
first
really
down
close.
Marker. Yeah,
wow.
This is really close. They're going to
they're gonna come up a yard short, right?
Almost got it.
It looked like he was going to be stopped about 5 yards short, but gets that close to it.
So the only scoring here in the third quarter, 9-yard touchdown run by Cressman to make it 49-14. If you're just joining us, Penn Argyl went on top early in this one, an 81-yard touchdown via the kickoff return. First play of the game by Alex Moser, then a 90-yard touchdown pass from Brad Rissmiller, Alex Moser, and then Tominski followed, 15-yard touchdown run. Jump out by a score of 22-0. Here in the third, Cressman pressure. He gets hit as he throws, gets it to Days, and Days gets hit at the end of that play, and then there's a flag thrown.
I think there might be maybe a face mask at the end of the play. Or block in the back.
Days slow getting up also.
Looks like he's cramping.
Yep. Try to get up, went back down. St. Luke's trainer is busy last night, busy again today, tonight. Doing a great job, for sure. I think John Hoth, Ken Sidlow, Greg Lay. Their partnership here with D11 Sports. You know, a shout out to our student reporters last night. Did a great job, you know, hitting a lot of different schools and putting out some highlights on Twitter, shooting out some articles earlier today as well on D11Sports.com. Right now, 2:20 left here in the third. 49-14 is your score in favor of the Green Knights. We'll be in New Tripoli on Thursday as the Tigers host Northern Lehigh. It'll be the Tigers' home opener, so I'm sure that will be a packed place. So Days is going to walk off on his own. See when they get him back in as well.
Yeah, I'm trying to think because I know last night was another hot and humid night. And I'm not quite sure if we had that many hot, humid days or anything during the whole preparation that these kids have gone through since the beginning of August.
I remember during heat acclimatization, they jokingly said to Tim Montzman at practice, they go, oh, it's hot out here. And he said, quote, this is ridiculous because it was so cool.
You know, and then you get these 2 days, opening night and Saturday the next day, these hot and humid days, and you get the kids, they're not prepared for it physically, and they're cramping up.
Cressman has a lot of room to run, and when I said that, that got changed real quick. He gets taken down.
I think the adjustment at halftime for Penn Argyl was defensively, we're going to rush our four, but you guys in the linebacking, the second level guys, you need to make sure you have eyes on quarterback. You need to make sure if he breaks contain or comes up through the line, you need to be in a position to make a tackle.
Looking at throws, Cressman has a receiver, incomplete. Was looking downfield for Nathan King.
Yeah, good coverage, too, on the play. Looked like number 12, A.J. Sora. He's right with him step for step. But Cressman puts the ball right where only his receiver can get it.
And the last night there was a lot of cramping all around. And, you know, and again, like you said, when there's beautiful weather and the humidity is low and all of a sudden you get to, I think this morning, the humidity at 9 o'clock in the morning was 83 already. Oh, a big block. And Fekete trying to come back and get that one that goes through and incomplete.
And on that play, Cressman takes a big shot from the Penn Argyl defense.
Yeah, he's going on the sideline here.
We'll see if Wilson decides to punt the ball away.
Well, they're going to have to either call a timeout here or punt because that clock is not going to. Oh, maybe
they're going. Yeah, they're going to
let
them
do it. Okay.
Let that quarter run out.
So three in the books. As the clock does wind down, the only touchdown was Cressman, 9 yards, 49-14, as you hear the horn sound in favor of Penn Argyl. It's our D11Sports.com Game of the Week, presented by St. Luke Sports Medicine, back after this.
Hall of Fame pitcher Steve Carlton knows what it takes to exceed expectations. He knows what it means to be part of a team that rises above the competition. He knows a champion. Steve Carlton knows St. Luke's Orthopedic Care.
At St. Luke's Orthopedic Care, you can trust us with your hands, feet, shoulders, hips, and knees. Because healthy bones and joints mean you can do more. You can trust us to recommend the right approach to care, including joint-sparing treatments and therapies. And when surgery is the only choice, we offer options to help you heal faster, including technology-assisted joint replacements and muscle-sparing hip surgery. St. Luke's, the orthopedic care you trust, now more than ever.
We are back as we get ready for the fourth quarter. 49-14 in favor of Penn Argyl. So it's fourth down and 11. This one straight up. And Penn Argyl will have good field position. This quarter brought to you by JFR Salvage, full-service scrap metal recycling company serving the Lehigh Valley for nearly 50 years. JFR will pay you cash for all grades of scrap metal, including iron, steel, copper, brass, aluminum, stainless, and junk vehicles. Competitive pricing and superior service are just a few reasons why you choose JFR Salvage for your scrap metal needs. Please visit their website, jfrsalvage.com, or one of the locations in Wingap or East Stroudsburg. Anthony Graziani, who starred here. Boy, you know, when he played here, you know, he played. Look at those quarterbacks that stand out here, and he played the D-back, and then went out to Lehigh. He just stood out.
Yes, he did. And he had also a great supporting crew around him as well. It made it a lot easier to stand out.
Underway here in quarter number four. Green Knights on the handoff to Hunter. Hunter nowhere to go. Matt's funny because, you know, everybody uses that phrase, hard to believe it's week one, hard to believe it's week five. You know, we're going to be there soon, and then we're going to say hard to believe anyway. But, you know, you wait all summer, and these players are practicing nonstop in the summertime and then finally getting going in August. And, you know, they wait for these kind of moments.
Yeah, the season kind of snuck up on me. You know, I knew practice started.
You didn't know it starts in August?
No, I knew it started. And, you know, the days went on, the days go on, the weeks. And, like, wait, hold up. We have a game tomorrow.
That's why I had to call you. You were, like, hanging out at the beach, relaxing, and I had to ship you guys
absolutely.
Back in. Second down and 13. Ball to 48. They keep it on the ground. And
oh, that's.
And that was Jayon Edwards, who came in with a hard tackle.
Yeah, Jaden Hunter went down hard on his head. You see 61 right in the middle of the defensive line. He comes through. He's able to get there and then just puts him down hard. And he hits his head pretty bad.
Yeah, he's coming to sideline.
You definitely want to take him out and take a look at him.
So 9:30 on the clock.
So number 7, Anthony Beltran, comes in at quarterback for Penn Argyl for this drive.
Again, opportunity if you're coaching staff, whether you're winning or losing, to check out your personnel because you may need them down the road. And they give you all that practice time. They're working their butt off. On the ground they stay. And this time, breaking through one, they get to the outside. Could be an opportunity, and taken down was Zachary Metzger. Did a lot of running there for only a couple yards.
And number 11, Ian Fekete, he's the one who comes up and finally corrals him for the tackle. But, yeah, nice job running, eluding a bunch of Wilson tacklers before Fekete brings him down. Wilson had two guys go off and only one guy. Now another guy comes on.
That one goes off Rissmiller's side of his foot. So Wilson will get great field position. Give one final shout out tonight to, or this afternoon, to Culligan Water. Culligan Water asks, when is the last time you had your water tested? Get a free in-home water assessment from Reynolds Culligan. Visit yourwater.net, yourwater.net for more information. Culligan Water. You know, Matt, sometimes you look at that the clock and change, you know, how that clock, if someone's, it's going to stop at certain points, obviously, with the mercy rule, but sometimes it just keeps on going. It's one of those games that you want to see it just keep on going. If you're, you know, Penn Argyl, you just want to just kind of make sure, both teams really want to make sure that despite the score being at the hand, you're getting the younger guys in, but at the same time, you don't want to get any hurt, and we saw that before. As, you know, it was a Hunter that came over to the side of the field.
Yeah, you want to make sure you get out of here healthy. For both teams, they want to make sure that happens.
Cressman being chased, and now he's going to have to go. I mean, overall, you look at Cressman running today. When he did, he was very effective.
He was. And, you know, he's breaking contain, getting out in space. He's still looking down the field, still trying to make a play, but has been very successful with his legs.
The ball down to the 38-yard line. Oh. Well, Days made the catch, but he got popped immediately afterwards on the play.
It was Isaiah Adams, number 33, his sophomore, comes up with the great open field tackle.
Listed at 5'7", 130, but he got all of this hit.
He comes up and boom, right in the chest. Does a nice job wrapping up, bringing him down to the ground.
Coaches like to see that. A little flare outside. Gets over to Bronson, and Bronson breaks a tackle, and he gets inside the 20-yard line. Penn Argyl player down.
And I believe he came down on the back of the heel, the cleat, during the tackle. Looked like that was in the midsection or maybe slightly lower.
So they'll check him out. He's on the, all the way on the far side. If you're a student from any District 11 school and you're interested in broadcasting, journalism, or photography, check out d11sports.com. Follow your dream. Get close to the action. Take part in our student internship program. For more information, contact your athletic director. Reach out to myself or Dave at d11sports.com. Braden Kresnopera, who's a center for Penn Argyl Green Knights, is one of our student reporters. Down there, Chase Eller from Wilson. As well, we've had a number of students from Penn Argyl take part in our program. And if you're interested, just give us a shout. Oh, good sign. St. Luke's, the region's largest sports medicine provider, covering more than 200,000 student enrollment and 40,000 student athletes in Pennsylvania and New Jersey, covering 8 counties and providing the most comprehensive and advanced treatment for athletic injuries. St. Luke's offers athletic training, orthopedic care, physical therapy, and concussion management, plus sports performance training for individual athletes and teams. During these extraordinary times, you can trust St. Luke's Sports Medicine to provide extraordinary care. Clock rolls once again, 5:20 and counting. And on the ground, a big opening, flying through it, trying to get inside of 5, and does, all the way down to about 3.5-yard line. Is Ronnie Bronson slowly getting up, right? Yep.
Yeah, not sure if it's a cramp or an injury. Like he rolled his ankle. I mean, it was close to the horse collar tackle, but he grabbed it but then let go and didn't bring him to the ground. This looks like it might be an injury.
He's in pain. No speculation, but it looked like they're working on that leg area, like towards the knee. When you see a player slap the ground, you know that.
I think it's more than a cramp then.
On this side for Brady Mutt and his team.
A good sign seeing him get up and try to walk off.
That's a great sign. Mutton, came in. We talked to him before the game, and he just, you've coached for a lot of years. When you practice so much, you just want to see a different color out there. And all right, I'm ready.
Yeah, we asked him. He was uptight at tightly wound the beginning of the game. Like, coach, this is the fun part.
Pressman to throw. Feckety.
He was like, I want to get out here and see what our guys can do. You know, he said they had a great scrimmage last week, with a lot of competition against Old Forge. It's a scrimmage. You can only take so much out of that. He wanted to see his guys in game situation. And I think he saw a lot of good stuff today.
You hear Wilson right here. You want to punch us in. You really have to.
I think you have to, yes.
A They'll go in from 2 yards. So Crespin with the touchdown. So Crespin with all three touchdowns, two on the ground and one through the air to Rodney Bronson for 63 yards. Has one from 9 on a run and this one from 2. And it comes at 4:02. Nicholson Louis June with the extra point, and that one is no good.
And it looked like Isaiah Adams again getting in there and making a play.
49-20.
Oh, 4 minutes left. Do you think with the kickoff and the offensive series, this might be the last drive?
Yeah, I would think so. I mean, you're Wilson. You know, you did what you had to do there, really. To, you know, you've scored 2 touchdowns in the second half. You know, we always say you want to get some momentum to build when a game's out of reach. Some momentum to build as you go to next week. And I think you've seen that today, you know, with Wilson there, he's scoring 2 touchdowns here. Here, Penn Argyl, again, you got a bunch of, you know, backup players in there. You know, do they get a good run and see if they can punch one in and get this backup group a touchdown as well?
Yeah, I'd like to see it. I know Coach Mutton would like to see his offense get something going at this point in time with the younger guys in.
So inside 4 minutes. I want to thank our sponsors today, as always, New York Life, JFR Salvage, Michael R. Glovis, financial advisor at Morgan Stanley in Easton, St. Luke's, of course, and Culligan Water for jumping on board here in 2023. As we get ready for, as of right now, 14-game schedule that we have. And our next matchup will be Thursday night in New Tripoli with Northern Lehigh at Northwestern. Really a couple snaps here, Matt, and should be enough. That one skips on the ground. Well, a good sign is Jaden Hunter's back in the game.
That is a great
sign.
That's
you know, if
Absolutely.
You look at anything like that, you get drilled to the ground, you hit the back of your head, and he's back in. That's a great sign.
And unfortunately, a bad snap there just causes the break in the play. Does it look like there's some decent blocking out in front? Yeah, Hunter, when he sees that on film, he's going to see he should have followed his lead blocker, Beltran, who stepped up inside. He ran out into the tackle of Fekete. He had some room inside where he could have ran.
Hunter.
Looks like Penn Argyl will go for it on fourth
down. Yeah, I was gonna say this is.
We have a timeout. Wilson.
So Wilson calls a timeout. Not that many timeouts today. Timeout brought to you by Culligan Water. Culligan Water asks, when is the last time you had your water tested? Get a free in-home water assessment from Reynolds Culligan. Visit yourwater.net for more information. Culligan Water Company. can now do you punt the ball away?
Well, I think the problem is, and you saw it in the last punt,
no, it was
if you punt it away, you're bringing your starters back on the field. And I think they've been sitting around for this entire half. You really don't want to put Riss Miller out there cold and to punt and have risk him getting hit. I think you just go for it and see what happens and then get your defense ready to go out and play.
Looking to throw. Near side. Hangs up there. That could have been a flag. And still comes up with a catch.
And it looks like it's going to be a first down.
Wow. So, watch Larry Lado makes his catch. He was tugged.
There's a little contact there. Right there. He does a nice job going up. Almost one hand catch, but able to get enough of that second hand in there to secure the catch and then pull forward for the first down. That should effectively be the end of it. We have under a minute left in the game. Should be just one play.
So 42 seconds left here at Alumni Stadium. Snap, they'll take a knee. And that one will wrap this one down as Penn Argyl is going to win this one by a score of 49-20. So the Green Knights go out to a 1-0 mark. And Wilson falls to 0-1.
Green Knights win!
Matt, your thoughts?
You know, Penn Argyl came out ready to go. They have a couple mistakes to clean up as they get ready for their next week and moving forward. I think Coach Mutton has been in a great position, has a lot of skill players. For Wilson, I think they just need to get back to work, find some more playmakers, find some guys that want to get out there, and find a way to get the ball to Fekete, get the ball to Bronson, Day, get the ball out to the perimeter in space so that those guys can make plays. They were able to make guys miss off that first tackle, but they need to be able to get the ball to them more consistently and have the offensive line protect a little more consistently.
I shut off that scoreboard so fast. I'm glad I wrote the score down over here just to make sure. Waiting for our player of the game with Chase Eller. They're going to talk to the team first. So while they're talking to the team, we'll try to give you some highlights from today, Matt.
So it all started off with the opening kickoff. Alex Moser, 81 yards. And in 12 seconds, Penn Argyl had their 2023 season starting off in a great way. After a penalty, they go for two. And they're up 8-0 with 12 seconds to go, or 12 seconds out of the game. This was a long conversion to Alex Moser as well. I believe it was 90 yards to Alex Moser on a conversion from third down. And, again, able to outrace the defenders into the end zone. And it was a lot of the big plays, but it was also a lot of patient running today. Came back here with Damian Tominski taking a direct snap, plants up the middle. He sees that hole open up, wide open, 15-yard touchdown run. And at that point, that puts him up 22-0 before the first quarter was over. Wilson was able to get on the board here. Crespin finds Bronson for a 63-yard touchdown. Bronson, again, like the Wilson receivers today were able to do, they were able to break that first tackle and able to get out in space and make some plays. That time Bronson was able to make the Knights pay for it and able to get into the end zone. From there, it came back to the Green Knights. It was all the Green Knights. This was Caden Faust, 8 yards, just following his blockers, letting them set up. I'm sorry, it was Tominski for 11. Able to set up the blockers and just take his time and weave his way into the end zone. I think we're going to get Penn Argyl here with the alma mater. Here it was Moser again taking it from the 40, I believe it was a 48-yard line. He takes the screen pass. That was on a convert, third down conversion, I believe, again, and he runs it in. Big game for Alex Moser today. Started off well, finished strong. Here, Crespin in the second half with the nice pass play to Ian Fekete. He finishes off that drive into the end zone for a 9-yard touchdown run to get the Wilson offense rolling in the second half a little bit. But just in the end, it was too much Green Knights early, and Wilson wasn't able to get anything rolling to get back into it.
Good highlights. Thanks, Sean Riley. He was right on par today. And, you know, sometimes you bring your A game, sometimes you don't. Looks like Sean did today. I'm quite surprised, to be honest with you. Okay, I want to thank Tim Egan for his hospitality here. And also to Jeff Breininger, the athletic director at Wilson, for getting us all their information. We always ask. We need the information beforehand so we can get it and get it all on ready to go. Right now, though, you know, there was a couple players that have big games tonight, but, you know, we know who our D11 Sports Player of the Game is, and we'll go down right now to Chase Eller.
Okay. I'm here with Alec Moser. He is our Player of the Game. How does it feel to set the tone and start the year off right?
It feels great. The whole team has been working all summer long. I mean, we were just counting down the days, and, I mean, that's all it came down to. We were just ready.
What are you looking forward to most next week?
Just continuing the tone. I mean, we all got a good mindset now going into the next week, and we're just going to keep the thing rolling.
All right. Thank you. Great game today. Back to you guys.
Hey, great game.
All right, Chase, thanks a lot. Great job by Chase on the sideline as well. That'll do it for us. Again, we'll be in New Tripoli for Northwestern and Northern Lehigh on Thursday night. For Sean Riley, Sports Fan Base Network, for Matt Evancho, I'm Al DeColo saying so long. Enjoy the rest of your Saturday afternoon. Penn Argyl on the hill, Windsor opener, 49-20, the final. Have a great day.